Welcome to my how-to series for Google Sheets. I've been getting a lot of requests from people asking how I create my spreadsheets, so today I'm excited to show you how to make your own cute to-do list spreadsheet in Google Sheets. It's such a helpful tool to have, and the best part? It's super beginner-friendly to create. So come along with me as I walk you through each step to build your very own to-do list spreadsheet from scratch. The first thing that you want to do is head over to your Google Drive by entering drive.google.com in your browser. Now, click on New at the top left corner and select Google Sheets. This will open a new spreadsheet. The first thing I like to do is to add the name of my file at the top left corner. I do this to make sure that I can find my file in my Google Drive in the future. Now that this is done, the fun part begins. I start by creating a box for the name of my spreadsheet. Select cell B2, then while holding down the Shift key, select D3. Click on the Merge Cells button. Then align the text by using the provided tools. I like to have large titles, so I change the font to 16. Select the border menu and choose the color that you want and the perimeter border button. I selected a thicker line to make the border more evident. Select columns B and C and resize them to 20 by right-clicking on the selection and selecting Resize Selected Columns. Now, let's start creating the table. In the first column, I will enter numbers for the tasks. In the second, check boxes to mark my tasks as complete. Then, the to-dos. In the fourth column, category. Fifth, priority. Sixth, due date. And finally, notes. In the number column, go ahead and type 1, 2, and 3 in the first three cells. Then, select all three cells. You'll see a small blue dot in the bottom right corner. Click and drag it down the column. Google Sheets will automatically continue the number sequence for you. Next, we're going to add checkboxes so we can check off our tasks as we complete them. Click on the first cell in the row where you want the checkboxes to go. Then head up to the Insert menu and choose Checkbox. Now that we've added one, you can even change the checkbox color by using the text color option in the toolbar. This is a fun way to match the style of your spreadsheet. Once it looks how you want, just drag that first checkbox down the column, just like we did with the numbers earlier. It'll automatically fill the rest of the cells with checkboxes. To help with this tutorial, I'm going to add a few example tasks to my to-do list. This will make it easier to show you how everything works as we go. Now let's create a drop-down list under the category column. There are two ways to do this, but this is my preferred method. Right-click on cell E3 and select drop-down from the menu. This will open the data validation panel on the right side of your screen. Here, you can enter the options you want to include in your category list. For example, you might use work, personal, or errands. Once you've added your items, you can also choose a color for each one to keep things organized and visually clear. I'm going with a rainbow theme for this to-do list, using the preset colors that come with Google Sheets. Now click Done. Just like before, drag the corner of the cell down to copy the drop-down to the rest of the table. You can try your drop-down to see how it looks and if you would like to adjust the colors. For the priority column, we'll do the same thing we did for the category column. Right-click the cell, select drop-down, and enter your options. For the selections, I like to use urgent, high, medium, and low. Just like we did for the categories, we'll choose colors that match each priority level. And again, drag that cell down to copy the drop-down list all the way to the bottom of the table. Later, I will use this column to show you how to use the sort function integrated in Google Sheets. I will take a moment to fill it out. One of the features I really enjoy in Google Sheets is the mini calendar. To add it to the cells under the due date column, click on the first cell, go to the data menu, and select data validation. In the panel on the right, click add rule. Under criteria, replace dropdown by selecting is valid date. Now click done, and drag the cell down to update all the cells in that column. You can use the mini date picker calendar by double-clicking on any cell. Select the date that you wish by clicking on the number of the day. To change the format of the date, select the first cell of the column, then scroll down and while holding the Shift key on your keyboard, click on the last cell. Select the 123 icon from the menu. Choose Custom Date and Time. Select your preferred format and click Apply. An important part of any spreadsheet is formatting. It not only makes your spreadsheet look better, but also helps keep everything clear and organized. In the next part of this video, I'll walk you through how to format your to-do list. We'll look at things like adjusting column widths, aligning your text, and adding some color to make your list easier to read and more fun to use. Little changes can make a big difference, so let's get into it. To start, let's add some color to the table headers. Select the desired cells, then click on the paint bucket icon to fill them with your preferred color. I want to add a border around the table to create a clear visual outline, and conveniently, the filter function does this automatically. This useful tool will also allow me to sort my entries with ease. To add a filter to your table, select cell B5 at the top left corner of your table. Then, while holding down the Shift key, select cell H40 at the bottom right corner. Go to the data menu and select Create a Filter. Now you can sort all of the data in your table. To do this, select the sorting icon next to a column title like the due date. Select Sort A to Z if you want to sort the dates in ascending order. You can sort by any column, but sometimes the default sorting order may not be ideal. When sorting my priorities, I want to maintain the order in which I entered them. To do this, I need to open the data validation menu by clicking the pencil icon and adding a number before each priority. This will allow me to sort my priorities in their original order. When making modifications to a drop-down list, make sure to select Apply to All. This will update all the cells in that column. We can now sort our entries from urgent to low. To resize a column, click and drag the edge of the column header until it reaches the desired width. To keep everything looking neat and tidy, I like to remove grid lines. You can do this by going to the View menu and unchecking the Grid Lines option. I want to add light gray grid lines inside my table. To do this, I'll apply a thin, light gray border to all the cells within the table using the Border tool. This will help keep the table structured while maintaining a clean and subtle look. In this cell, I want to create a box that automatically calculates the total number of tasks that I have listed. I added a border around the box to define this area. The formula I used counts only the cells where I have entered information, ignoring any blank ones. I want to adjust column D to give more room for my tasks by increasing its width. And just like that, you have your own personalized to-do list spreadsheet. Now that it's complete, let me show you how to print a copy by removing all unnecessary blank cells for a cleaner layout. To enter the print menu, you can either go to the File menu at the top left corner or hold down the Control key and press P. Make sure that your setting is set to Fit to Page. As you can see, we have a lot of empty cells. To remove these, exit the print menu. Click on the Filter button next to the To-Do title. Here, uncheck blanks. Now that you have removed the blank rows, go back to the print menu. Your to-do list is ready to be printed. The filter tool can be extremely useful once you've added a lot of tasks. Not only can you use it to remove blank entries, but you can also filter out specific task categories you don't need or exclude low-priority tasks. This helps keep your to-do list focused and organized, making it easier to manage what really matters. If you liked this tutorial and found it helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more tips on staying organized and productive. Let me know in the comments what you'd like me to create next. I'd love to hear your ideas. Thanks for watching, and happy organizing!